ready to celebrate Mother's Day, and I'm going to make for you today one of my recipes for scones. This is a sort of a traditional scone recipe, cream recipe, so very creamy and delicious. And the nice thing about them is because they're somewhat plain, it's all about what you put on top of them. So it gives you an opportunity to perhaps give it as a gift with a fresh jar of preserves to go with it, or in this case, I also like to serve it with a fresh lemon curd, which I'll show you how to make also. So to start off, we have here a bowl that with 2 cups of flour. I've also added 1/8 of a teaspoon of salt to that. Next up, we need 2 teaspoons of baking powder in there as well. And I'm going to give that a quick stir around just to incorporate the ingredients. And then we're also going to put 1/4 cup of sugar. Now I also have here 1/3 cup of butter. And what I've done is I've cut it into sort of small chunks, 1/2-inch chunks is fine. And I'm going to take those and I'm going to sprinkle them, try and sprinkle them sort of throughout the butter. Now, if you have a pastry knife, you could also utilize that. A pastry cutter, you can cut the butter into the flour, but the idea is to get this all incorporated in. And then once that's in there, we're going to take 2 knives, and I'm going to use a sort of manual scissor style way of cutting this in. So 2 knives, scissors going across, and what you want to do is just keep cutting. And as you do this, you're going to cut the chunks of butter into the flour, and it's going to start to resemble smaller pieces. We're going to try and get it to where it looks sort of like pea-sized shape pieces. So now you can see my butter and flour incorporated, and the butter's in smaller pieces. And it's ready to go. And so what we want to do is mix our liquid ingredients. So I have 1 egg in here that I will beat a little bit. And I'm going to add to that 1/2 cup of heavy cream. And we're also going to use 1 1/2 teaspoons of vanilla. And give that a quick stir, and then we're gonna incorporate it into our flour mixture. Get as much of the good cream out of there as possible. And give this a stir to incorporate it all. Make sure you scrape the bottom, get all the flour up into the liquid. And then we're gonna flour surface and turn this out onto the surface where we can pat it a little bit. So this is all nicely incorporated now. If you want, you can go ahead and continue on, but optional would be to add 1/2 cup of raisins or currants to the mixture. I like having a little raisin in my scone. So I'll go ahead and get those incorporated in here somewhat evenly. And we're gonna flour. It works surface a wood board, or if you have a stone counter, as I do, you can just put it right out onto here. And we're gonna pat this out by hand. You don't need to get a roller or anything like that. And you're gonna use your hands to pat this into a, probably wanted to have about maybe 1/2-inch of thickness. or something along those lines. And I use a cookie cutter. Normally I'd get a 2.5 inch round cookie cutter and go ahead and cut this out and put it onto a buttered cookie sheet. But since it's Mother's Day, I'm going to make hearts this time. See, they're nicely crumbly, which is a good sign that they're going to be good and flaky when they come out of the oven. And that's it. You're going to go ahead and bake these in the oven. You're going to at 425, and it should cook for about 15 minutes. But watch them. You want them to be sort of brown on top. So to do the citrus curd, I'm going to start with 2 whole eggs and 2 egg yolks in a small bowl. And what you want to do is just whisk them together so that they're combined. Then we're going to take this over to our saucepan and we're going to add to it 1/3 cup of fresh squeezed lemon juice, 1/3 cup for fresh squeezed orange juice. We have 1 teaspoon of the zest of the lemon, 1 teaspoon of the orange zest, and we 3/4 cup of sugar. Also have here 1/3 cup of butter, unsalted butter, which I've cut into cubes to help it incorporate a little bit quicker. And now we can move on over to the stove. So I brought our eggs over to my saucepan, which I have on medium heat, and have that started to heat up a little bit. We're gonna add to it the orange juice. Fresh lemon juice. Three quarters a cup of sugar, which I'm going to add slowly so that it dissolves nicely. Next, we're going to add the zest. And then finally, the cubed butter, 1/3 cup butter. Cook this slowly over medium heat. You want to get it, sort of bring it to a boil. Don't overcook it, because then it will curdle. So you just got to watch it carefully, keep stirring it. And when you see it start to bubble just a little bit and thicken up, then you know it's time to take it off the burner. All right, so you'll see now the mixture starting to boil a little bit, and it's getting good and thick. So now this is pretty much done. What we're going to do is remove it from the heat. I'm going to put it right into a heat-proof glass bowl. And we're going to let it cool for a few minutes on the counter. I'm going to cover it with plastic wrap, put it in the fridge, chill it all the way down. And this will be your topping for scones. Cooling wrap with a spatula and let them cool down. If you're going to eat them right away, then you can go ahead and eat them in 5 minutes. Otherwise, you can let these cool down all the way and put them in a plastic tight-fitting container to give away as a gift. All right, so we have our finished scones, and so as a gift, as a present for Mother's Day, we have a few scones together with a nice jam. This is a gooseberry with elderflower jam from Blake Hill Preserves in Vermont. This is a good food award-winning company, and make